Hello everybody, I'm going to present you today how to use this cheap multimeter to measure voltage. Alright, so let's get started. So this is a multimeter, as you should know by now. With this one you can measure voltage, amp, continuity, resistance and so on. The topic of today is how to use this digital multimeter to measure voltage, as we have written here with these funny letters. Alright, first thing first, you're gonna see on this multimeter it's got this range here. This is a DC, which means direct current, or more simple, batteries, like so, bigger, small or whatever. And you got a range here from 200 millivolts, 2000 millivolts, 20 volts, 200 and 1000 volts. On the other side, we have the AC voltage, which stands for alternating current. And you have this sign. Basically, it's fluctuating back and forth, 50 times per second. That means 50 hertz, the stuff that you have on your plug. All right, so the first thing first, we have the multimeter, yeah, a digital multimeter, and we're gonna have these special connectors here. As you can see on this side, it's got three connectors. COM stands for negative or black, and two more here. This one, as you can see, V and ohm is voltage, and on these settings we're gonna measure just voltage, one of those kind of voltage, no, direct voltage or alternating voltage. Alright, so let's get started. DC voltage stands for direct current, as I told you, or put it simple, batteries. Alright, now let's put it to the 20 range here, and let's take one of these lithium ion cell. I'm gonna put it like so. Plus and minus, here we go, we have 4 volts. And we have no sign in front of the 4 volt. That means the polarity is correct. You heard it right, folks. Polarity. When you are talking about voltage and volts in particular, you have to keep in mind about the polarity. Polarity means which one is plus and which one is negative. With the help of this digital multimeter, in the voltage section, you can find out the polarity as well. Because this leads, this one, the red one connected to the proper connection here, red, is going to indicate all the positive, and this one all the negative. So if you're going to connect it, doesn't matter how you're going to connect to a battery, it's going to show you a minus in front, which means that stuff is on the wrong polarity. Let's make a quick test here. So I said plus and minus. Here you go, you see the minus in front of the multimeters, because we have connected all this probe the wrong way around. Now let's put it on the good position. Bear with me for a while. Here we go. The minus sign that was in front of the 4 volts disappeared. That means now we have the right polarity for this stuff. This is plus and this is minus. And let's take another small battery. But you got the idea, you know. Just put it in this range. If you don't know, you're going to put it on 1000. And that's it. You're on a maximum range. But if you know or the approximate value of it, you can put it according to these terminals. We have this small battery, which is LR44. And let's check it to see what's the voltage of this small and tiny battery. Here we go. We got a minus and 1.25. Minus means that we have connected the plus here, but it's not. And according to the label of this tiny battery, just a second, here you go, you see that plus thingy shining on this corner, it's gonna show us that this side is the plus and the other one is the minus. So let's see, let's connect the thing, let's zoom in a little bit, this camera is not focusing right, so we have connected the plus there and here the minus, there you go, we don't have the minus in front of the multimeter, which means this is plus, the correct one, and this is minus. So you got the idea, yeah? DC current DC voltage, sorry, meaning batteries, all sorts of batteries you can measure with this stuff. And as well some transformers, some power output, that's gonna output a DC voltage. If you're gonna see the label DC, that's gonna mean like direct current, battery or appropriate batteries. All right. Now let's talk about AC. AC means for the current that you have on your block. Let me show you. Here you go, friends. Here is AC. This is your AC alternating current, your plug. In this case, an UK one is 240 volts. Yours can be 120, 110, 220, and so on. So this is AC, alternating current. For this section of the voltage as well, you have to turn your multimeter in this section over here. This is voltage, and you have this cricket sign, which is like a sine wave, which is actually what that means, you know, AC, alternating current, you know, go up and down, up and down, basically, and 50 hertz is like 50 times per second. So imagine that a pulsating thing 50 times per second. That's it. And now you can ask, you know, why I'm saying AC and DC when we are talking about voltage. Basically, current, doesn't matter if it's going to be like alternating current or direct current, it cannot outstand itself without volts, without voltage. So imagine that volts and voltage is the stuff that's going to push all the current through. It's kind of mumbo jumbo at the moment, but keep in mind how to measure voltage with a digital multimeter. And in the future video, we're going to talk about the current as well and how they are both connected together. All right. Thanks all for watching. In a minute, thumbs up, subscribe, play with this multimeter, all these settings over here, and see you on the next episode. Thanks. Bye.